Hello. Here today we are going to learn rangoli texture. Okay. See. For that we require any colored paper or white paper also will do. Fabric colors, rangoli powder, and Fevicol. Okay. So first what we have to do, we will make texture, then keep it for dry at least for 5-6 hours. Means texture how to do. Let's start. Okay, we will. It's very easy, students. So I'll show you. Whatever design you want, first you draw it. For example, here I am drawing. I'll draw with pen so that you will see it easily. Whatever design is, okay. Simple flower I am doing. Okay. That's up to you, design you will do or whatever. First you will draw, then with Fevicol you have to put outline or somewhere you have to fill it. See, now these are petals. I will put outline with Fevicol as well as I will fill it inside. Outside first I will put. Okay. I'll put here little and then with pointed something you have to give texture. Okay, this way you have to fill all the petals. Here I am showing again in outline. First you will put, here is also point, so with that even you can make texture. Line texture I am making, or fill it and after 5 minutes you will do texture, then also nicely texture you will get. Now it is wet, no? See texture you are getting. So that's up to you what texture you are making according to your design, and this way you will complete your full Fevicol work, and then on that you have to take little rangoli. Okay, rangoli powder you have to take. See this type of rangoli powder, and then you have to sprinkle it on this wherever it is Fevicol. Rangoli powder will fix on that area. Okay, and then whatever extra you have to remove it. Okay, you have to remove it this way. Even after this, if you feel that there is texture is covered, so you can do lines after putting your. See, I did like this. So this way you have to complete your texture all over in your design. Okay, here to save time, already one texture I have done. I'll show you. See, first I completed my drawing, then Fevicol texture I did, and on that I sprayed rangoli powder. After this you are getting like this. Okay, you must keep it for 5-6 hours for dry, then you'll get good result. Okay, so after dry now we have to start coloring. What we will do, whatever colors we require, with those colors see I started coloring. So after even coloring you will get that texture, you will get it relief. Even while applying color, you apply this way. little dark I will take. See, you will get that texture and even background color also. 3D effect you are getting. So okay, then trunk, what color you want you can color, take that for trunk. I am taking a yellow ochre because already my background is orange, so I am taking little light color and dark color for texture. Dark brown even I will take for trunk. Here even this coloring you can apply with sponge. Sponge also will give very nice effect. Acrylic small colors or metallic colors even you can use, you can use for see, first I did this. You, even here now I don't have sponge. If you have sponge, what next texture I am showing that you can do with sponge, that will give you better result. But instead of brush I will use one crumble. See, here even you are getting 3D effect. Okay, that's looking nice. But if you have some metallic colors, silver, bronze, metallic different shades, then you can use those colors. It will give you more nice effect. Now I will show you. I have some metallic shades. See, this is metallic shade I have, so I'll apply on this. If you have golden, silver, even you can use. Okay, not necessary, this much is enough. I'm showing some extra work. If you have color, you can use it. Now I don't have sponge, so what I did, I took one paper. Okay, I crumbled it, and with this base, I'm going to apply this metallic color on my tree. So what will happen? Only upper, which is 3D effect, 3D portion, that will shine. If you want, you can put it in the tree also. Only a relief portion will this all texture technique practice you will do. different textures you learn. So see, now it's shining, right? So this way you will continue your work. Okay, now even I have time, then what I'll do, in the background I'll put some color shades which will give me more nice effect. Blue, white blue, we will add light blue, you will get, and that even you can color in the background, or if you want you can keep clean as it is. Yes, if you have color, nice color background, don't change it. That's okay, just spread it little. Little texture I did in the background. So see, looking very nice. Now this small piece, now you are seeing that is very small piece I have done, but if you'll make like this small pieces, and when you stick it on the cardboard, on any dark color paper, and frame it, it looks very nice. Or you can use this for greeting card. Okay, make a little big size greeting card, stick it in the middle and just give border, that also looks nice. So this simple texture techniques will help you to make more creative work. Do it, enjoy it. Okay.